Welcome to Hood Champion Boxing and Sports. In boxing, you find a way to win, or you find a way to lose. Unless you have Robert Garcia in your corner, you're probably going to end up finding a way to win. Because Robert Garcia is the miracle worker. And I mean that. I've always known that there was something special about Robert Garcia and the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy. You take a look at when Marcus Maidana lost to Devin Alexander. Maidana was heading back to Argentina to sell papas fritas. His ass was on the decline. Somehow, man, stumbling along, and somebody knew somebody. Now he's out there working with Robert Garcia. And Robert Garcia turned Marcos Maidana's career around, turned his life around. And Maidana went on to get some big wins, but more importantly, was able to go on and land a big fight with Floyd Mayweather and did so good that Floyd rematched him. To this day, many people feel Maidana deserved to get the win in the first fight against Floyd. I don't see it that way. So to that I say, in the most respectful way, for those who think that, hey, you hold your horses and stop taking it to the stoop. But what I'm getting at is, to see what he did with Maidana, Brandon Rios. Brandon Rios was pretty much a simple ass fighter, man. And he had Brandon Rios out here tranquilizing people. And then you sit back and you see the different fighters that he works with. And whenever he's in the corner with a fighter, there's a 90% chance his fighter's going to win. So Robert Garcia, he's got his stuff together. His team has their stuff together. He's even brought his son along as being recognized as one of the best hand rappers in boxing today. But this thing about Virgil Ortiz and Bohachuk, right? Look, I gotta be real. I want to make sure that you guys hear this for you Virgil Ortiz fans. The Virgil Ortiz that was fighting at 147, I've done like 6,000 videos, so I can't even remember what video. I had to go find it and play it. I said that I think Virgil Ortiz would probably beat everybody. That's how powerful, explosive, fast, just how much of a beast he was in the ring. I'm like, ain't no way in the world Spence can handle that shit. And I'm like, he'd give Crawford hell. I said I think he would beat them all. But then he had the episodes with Rabdo. I'm like, that's not good, right? Anyway, he seems to push through it somehow. Then Flair Cobb comes out, says he was on steroids. Do my research, find out Rabdo is one of many side effects of steroids. So I'm like, holy, wow, Blair Cobb may have been onto something. Then they hit him with the cease and desist. He had to apologize, and you know, okay, life goes on, right? But then he has some time off from boxing. He returns, says he's going to campaign at 154 pounds, had two fights at 154, never made the 154-pound limit. And he did not look that great. He had two fights. Each fight was one round. So two fights, two total rounds. Well, he looked less than stellar, in my opinion. And the competition was nowhere near Bohachuk. Now, he was supposed to fight Tim Tszyu. And I said, Tim Tszyu is going to destroy Virgil Ortiz. Because Virgil Ortiz, again, I'm just going off of his last two fights at 154, the weight he did not make. I'm like, there's something wrong here. All of a sudden, he ends up with Robert Garcia. And now I'm saying to myself, oh, shit. He done hurt him and Robert Garcia, boy. We know he worked with him before. Robert Garcia. You know, that's what could be the thing. Is when he was working with Robert Garcia, he was looking like a monster. Left Robert Garcia, not so intimidating. Back with Robert Garcia, and I gotta say, I know what the Robert Garcia Academy can do for boxers. And can he help? Can he help Virgil Ortiz? I got to tell you, I think he can. I think he can. Do I still favor Bohachuk? This is the thing. I got to be real. What is it that Robert Garcia, right? This is the question. What is it that he's going to do that's going to whip Virgil Ortiz into the kind of shape and condition to be that monster he was at 147? Because at 154, I haven't seen it. Now, Virgil Ortiz, I don't know if he's working with Heredia. I don't know if he is working with Conte and Snack. I don't know what he's doing. But that shit that Robert Garcia had Valenzuela doing against Pitbull Cruz was absolutely amazing. So Robert Garcia is the miracle worker. Now, can he do that with Virgil Ortiz getting ready for Bohachuk? Like, I don't know. But if Virgil Ortiz comes in there and he makes 154, first thing I'm going to say is, okay, how did that happen? If he gets in that ring and he can fight like he did at 147 against Kavalioskas and Maurice Hooker, and he can do that from the first, second, the first round to wherever the fight ends, especially if he wins by knockout, I'm going to say, how did that happen? Because he hasn't shown at 154. Now, do I think he won't be making as many mistakes? I think his footwork could be better. He'd be a bit more polished. He'd get the ring rust off. I think so, because of the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy. And you go in there and you're training for a fight and to spar, and you get whatever, a little bit of ring rust, a little bit of barnacles that are inactivity, barnacles that are clinging to you. Oh, they knock that shit off, don't they? But right now, I just got to be real. I don't care about Virgil Ortiz having 100% KO ratio. That means nothing to me, because his last two fights to me don't count. This one counts. Bohachuk is a problem. You know what I'm saying? I don't care what anyone says. Bohachuk has won his last six fights and suffering the only defeat of his career back in 2021 against a guy named Brandon Adams. 24 wins, one loss, and 23 knockouts for Bohachuk. That's a serious-ass record. And we already know, man, with Ortiz, 21 wins and 21 knockouts. I'm just telling you. I'm just going to be paying attention. I think it's a tremendous matchup. But I'm going to have to wonder if Virgil Ortiz can really pull it together. And if he did, I wish I could get a hold of that fly on the wall to find out what he did to bring it together and get in the ring with Bohachuk and possibly stop him. Now, I know they spent time together. I know they had a lot of rounds. I understand. That's why it was easy to make the fight happen, because both of them feel like, hey, I know the guy, and I think I can get the victory. But what I'm going to tell you, I just think there's a little bit more that's going to meet the eye when they get in the ring, especially if Virgil Ortiz just runs through them. I'm telling you right now, I'm calling it. Some shit ain't going to, something's going to surface. Now, you talk about, do I think he's going to be on PEDs and all that? I'm not saying that. I just think that the bullshit flag's going to get thrown. Now, when it comes to him being with Golden Boy, I'm going to tell you right now, no, I don't trust Golden Boy at all. Now, Ryan Garcia and Devin Haney. Look, Devin Haney and his dad, you know, look, colorful personalities. But at the end of the day, De La Hoya and what they did with Ryan Garcia, I think that shit was shitty. But, you know, they didn't do nothing illegal as far as having Ryan come in 3 pounds overweight, you know, so. But that just shows you anything they can do to get an edge, an upper hand. And then whatever happened with Ryan and Osterine, I ain't here to get into that. But what I took from that is, this goddamn Oscar De La Hoya and Golden Boy, they'll do anything to get a victory. And Oscar will play stupid. But in my opinion, I think he knew everything that was going on with Ryan. I think he knew everything that was going on with Ryan. And he was in concert with everyone who made the decision for Ryan to be involved with whatever he was involved in, just so they could have the upper hand against Devin Haney. And I do believe when it comes to a guy like Virgil Ortiz, I mean, look at it. He had two fights at 154 and he never made the weight. So they're going to always make sure that, you know, they get whatever they can get away with. they're going to get away with so they can have the upper hand. And I think that De La Hoya is the ringleader with all the bullshit. But the bottom line is, with Robert Garcia being in Virgil Ortiz's corner, you know, forget De La Hoya, forget everybody. I think Robert Garcia makes a big difference. A big difference. I remember Freddie Roach. He was talking about when it came to who were they going to fight. Freddie Roach was, they were getting ready to get one of his fighters to face off against someone. It was Manny Pacquiao facing, who was he about to fight at 147? I don't know if it was Margarito. I think it was Margarito, but I can't remember. But anyway, what Freddie Roach said was, look, I'm not worried about Robert Garcia training Margarito. I'm worried about the old man, talking about Robert Garcia's dad. And that's what Freddie Roach said. But what I think is happening now, I just think Robert Garcia is just, with everything he learned from his dad and in his own personal career and from training fighters, I think Robert Garcia just has a brilliant boxing mind and he's a miracle worker. And I think he's going to help Virgil Ortiz a great deal. But I'm going to have to, I don't think they need to do anything shady. I think Robert Garcia is that smart to where he can really help Virgil Ortiz be more than competitive against Bohachuk. I'm going to be watching the gloves and everything else. Hopefully Bohachuk and his team are smart enough to be like, all right, what the hell is going on here? If there's any funny business. But I just think Robert Garcia by himself may be more than enough for Virgil Ortiz to get the victory. But that being said, I still have to go with looking at Virgil Ortiz's last two performances. I have a hard time picking him over Bohachuk. That's just me. But maybe he knows something that I don't, because he spent all the time sparring him. And maybe Bohachuk knows something that we don't. But I tell you what, it's going to be a good fight. I got Bohachuk winning the fight. I know my mind says Virgil Ortiz, but something in my heart telling me that Virgil Ortiz, he just doesn't look the same. People, I mean, he just doesn't look the same. I think that rhabdo took something out of him. I think it took a pound of flesh out of him. He doesn't look the same. He at 154, them two fights, maybe they just rushed him into those fights just to knock some ring rust off, and then boom. Now they're going to sit here and launch him to a big fight for a title. We're going to see if it was brilliance on the Golden Boy's part or if it was stupidity. And one thing I tell you is, I don't think Robert Garcia can be blamed if Virgil Ortiz does lose, which I think Virgil Ortiz will lose. I think Virgil Ortiz just would never be 100% again. Even though he's up at 154, I just, something about that rhabdo and the fact that he's never made 154, something just tells me they're afraid for him to cut weight. They're afraid. They're worried about his health. That's just me, man. Look, I'm not telling you I'm speaking facts. I'm just telling you. But me paying attention, something seems off of Virgil Ortiz. But that being said, I think Robert Garcia, I think he can help him. I do. But I don't know if that's going to be enough for him to get the victory. But if so, and depending on how he gets it, I'm going to have to sit there, man, and question some shit, because he hasn't looked a tenth of the fighter he was when he was fighting at 147. He hasn't looked anywhere near that since he's been at 154 for those two fights. So if he shows up and he looks like that beast he was at 147, I got to throw the bullshit flag and say, hey, whoa, how? You understand? How? Anyway, keep cool. Shout out to the veterans, all seven continents. Robert Garcia, man, is a brilliant brain, the miracle worker. Maybe he can work a miracle for Virgil Ortiz and get him that victory against Bohachuk in the brief.